Now, during the Prohibition in the 1920s, Capone quickly became public enemy number one.
Because the mafia was killing people, and he was getting them off.
He ordered the murders of scores of people. The only thing these guys would do would be to respond with violence.
His name was Easy Eddie. He was such a good lawyer that no matter what charges they had on Al Capone or his people, they couldn't put any of them in jail. He was so valuable that the mafia gave him enormous amounts of money, the best of cars, the best of everything. And he had a son. But Easy Eddie was thinking, I've given my son everything. Everything money could buy. But there's one thing I haven't given my son. An example of a father that he could be proud of. And Easy Eddie came to the conclusion, the only way I could give my son a father with a legacy of a good name is I have to help the government put the mafia in prison. He testified. And many of the biggest people in the mafia were put in prison. He knew full well that he would be killed for doing this. And one day he was riding in his car and another car came by and several people with machine guns filled his body with bullets and he laid on the street dead. He paid a very high price to give his son a father who he could be proud of. There was a man in the United States Air Force during World War II. He took off from his ship to go fight against the Japanese. He saw about 9 Japanese bombers coming toward the USS Lexington to sink the boat, and there were thousands of people on the boat. He was alone, and he decided, I have to stop them. So he single-handedly charged at these 9 airplanes and was shooting. And shooting and shooting, and he actually had 2 of them fall into the ocean. And then he ran out of bullets, and they were shooting at him and attacking him. And he was so fearless that he was flying at these different planes that were shooting at him, and he was knocking off their wings. And finally, after 5 of the 9 sank, the other 4 thought, this man is completely crazy, let's get out of here. And they all flew away. He was the first person in the U.S. Air Force in World War II to get the U.S. Congressional Medal of Honor, the highest award there is. His name was Butch O'Hare. And the airport in Chicago, O'Hare Airport, is named after him. He's considered one of the greatest heroes of American history because he was willing to sacrifice his own life for the higher cause of others. What makes this story so interesting is Butch O'Hara was the son of Easy Eddie. What are we giving our children? I've seen people work so hard for money, give it to their children, and then their children fight as enemies to see who gets it. Is that the legacy? Is that fulfilling life? Is that what we want to leave to the world? Our values, our character, the grace and the compassion of the love that flows through us is the greatest contribution we could make to our own life, to our families, and to the world. And when we have those values, and we work and we build that foundation, then we could have a wonderful, fulfilling, meaningful life beyond birth, beyond death. And we could leave that as a legacy for the world.